of emotions. How grateful I am that through them, I can enjoy and appreciate the life you've given me. I can relate to others in a meaningful way.
Stephanie, you remember that notion last week we talked about that we relate to others through our emotional experience? That way we can help them, because that's what it's all about, is helping each other. Go ahead, please.
And I can reflect your image to this hurting world. Mm-hmm. In faith, I claim that my emotions are a blessing from you and that you can work through them for my good and your glory. Lord God, I confess that at times I have allowed my negative feelings and false beliefs.
For me, that's a prayer of repentance. Because he says, I have allowed my negative emotions to what?
Feelings. False beliefs. Mm-hmm. To rule me.
Control me.
Allow them to stand in direct opposition to what you are doing in and through me. Okay. You promised that when we repent of mm-hmm. our sins, you are faithful and just to forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So I thank you, Father, both for forgiving me and for teaching me how to be free from the lies that keep me in bondage. Help me to be completely honest about how I feel and the struggles I have, where I am repressing and suppressing emotions. Please unearth them and show me how to verbalize what I feel to you. Where I have drowned my feelings and tried to escape them, please give me courage to bravely confront them. And whenever I am tempted to complain to a friend or grumble about something I am experiencing, please remind me to take my concerns to you first. Open your word to me, guide me in your truth, and help me to be obedient to you in every situation that may arise. Thank you, Father, for hearing my prayers and beginning the process of transforming the way I think. Thank you for setting me free from your truth and teaching me the boundaries that protect me and honor you. To you alone belong all glory, power, and praise and abundance. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
That's a good prayer. I wanted to end with that because this prayer can remind us when we become unbalanced. This prayer can help us get back in balance by the way we think and how we feel, to help us get back in balance. God bless you. God keep you. Next week we'll be Chapter 3, and I want to encourage you to look at it. Look at it. Because once we start looking at it and start allowing what we've already read to start to germinate within us, it begins starting a process of being better. And as we be better, we do better. Bad grammar, but good grammar. We'll be better, we'll do better. All right? God bless you. God keep you. Thank you again for coming out this evening on this cold, dropping the temperature evening.